think the mic is on now. Mic. You're the mic. Great. Let me just, 1, 2. Oh, the heck happened? 2, 2. Yep. Okay. Just making sure. Then we'll go across the street and work out with those girls. Eh? Okay, let's start with shoulder floss. Look at how crooked I am. Look. No, that's how bad my shoulder is. Okay, here we go. All the way up and back. That's how crooked I am. That's crazy. Kind of scary. I should go back to the chiropractor again. Oh, goodness me. Just the best way to get that shoulder back. Trying to get full half circle, but full half. My arms are just not cooperating. See, the more I try to fix it, the worse it gets. We're a mess. So another way to work on that shoulder is if you put your hand against the wall with your palm on it and then do half circle, forward and back, which I'm just doing with an imaginary wall. All right, let's test our balance before we go to the floor and stretch. I'm going to put that band aside because I will need it on the floor. All right, I'm going to test my balance. I'm going to put my hands in my chest. And I'm going to put 1 foot on my leg. What? Okay, so you think, oh, my balance is so good. Now close your eyes. Wah. See? All right, let's do the other foot. Test your balance. First, find your center of gravity. Then close your eyes. Isn't that funny how your eyes cue you for your balance? All right, chin to chest, nice and slow. We're going to do a toe touch and see just how tight the backs of our bodies are. And then when you get to the bottom, just let your arms hang. And do like a half circle, like a rainbow shape. And I always keep my knees a little bit bent because I'm a rebel against hyperextension. All right. And then nice and slow all the way back. Let's get those shoulders warmed up a bit. So I'm going to put my hands behind my head. I'm going to touch my elbows and then push my elbows as far back as I can. Whee. This is where you flex your bicep. No. Blunk, blunk. And then I'll take my right arm, go straight up, drop it behind my head, grab my elbow, and do a bit of a pull. Stretch that shoulder. Deep breath in. Resistance is futile. All right, left arm straight up, drop behind your head. Grab the elbow, bit of a pull in, and stretch that shoulder. Deep breath in. Palms up, elbows bent, palms just right in front of you like you're holding a tray of tequila. Now move your hands as far out as you can. and then just drop them to the floor, and you'll feel your scapula reset in the back. Let's do it again. Deep breath in, hands out, drop them to the floor, breathe out. All right, it's time to go to the floor. So now you could either go on your hands and knees and do this, or you could walk down into a high plank, or you can keep your knees on the floor. And then I'm gonna take my left foot and put it by my left hand. Nice big stretch with that hip. And then I'll take my left hand that's by the foot and loop it under the arm and towards the ceiling. And your eyes should follow that hand. Okay. So again, if you're doing modified, you'd have one knee down. And then I would do that. You ask for a thoracic stretch, you get it. So you could either do this next move with your knee down or stay in that plank position. Take your hands on either side of your foot. Come all the way up and reach for the sky. So you could have that back knee down if you need. See, we're messing with the balance again. Back down, hands on the floor. Let's switch feet. Okay, so I'm gonna put my right foot on my right hand. And I'm gonna loop it under the arm. Follow that in. Back down. I like this one because it stretches just not only the thoracic spine along the ribs, but also the hip and the inner thigh. Thread the needle. And again, you can keep your knee down or one more time. And then I'm gonna move my hands to either side of my foot. And come up and reach. There we go. Perfect. Back down. Let's go onto our hands and knees. We're going to do the 90-90 position. Right. So I'm going to push. I have my left foot forward. I'm just gonna lean forward and stretch this hip. So in order to get a really good stretch on the hip, I have to keep my spine straight and lead with that hip bone pushing forward. Not so much the knee, but the hip. Now if you wanna take it a little further, so this, my right leg is the back leg, so that's the arm I'm gonna use. It's gonna go straight up. I'm gonna push my hip out as I put my arm over my head. And if you want, push a little more forward. Really stretch in there. Feel that stretch, Mike? Good. Then just come back to center so you get that nice 90-90. We're gonna do that thoracic again. So two hands forward and go all the way back. Didn't have to go in an angle, you could have went straight. Back forward. Now this time, instead of going straight back, do a half circle until you're straight. And then half circle back to your hand. When you do the half circle, turn your palm out. Forward. So good for the shoulder, I think. I'm going to switch sides. All right. So again, push the hip forward, leading with the hip, not so much the knee. A really good way to do it is if you push your hip forward, Keep your spine really straight. So the back, my back knee right now is my left. So I'm going to put my left arm up, reach it over my head and push my hip out and forward, out and forward. Woo. I always am so surprised that my left hip is always tighter. It used to be my right hip, and then I had that surgery on my right knee, and so my left took over, I think. Okay, back to center, hands together. It's like an alligator stretch kneeling. So for some reason you couldn't kneel, you could do this lying on your side. Okay, let's do palm out, half circle, all the way to the back, and then back to front. Try to always have these nice square straight lines when you finish your movement. And back forward. Whee. That was so much fun. Great. Let's get off our knees. I know as you get older, going on your knees without a pillow. So you could use a pillow if you wanted. It's actually kind of hurts though. Okay, without a pillow, I mean. All right, so pinwheel position. So kind of like a 45 degree angle behind each knee. Okay. Arms at your chest, or you can keep them on the floor, and we're gonna do circles with the body. Really try and keep your spine like straight so you're not bending your torso, you're moving it as one piece. Okay, change direction. Still in the pinwheel position. This back knee, right now that's my left. I'm gonna push into the floor as hard as I can. And then I'm gonna turn my body away. Still pushing that knee in. And don't forget to breathe. Push the knee in, deep breath. Let it go. Twist that body. Come back to front. And this time we're gonna go into a 90-90 position. So 90 degrees behind every, even the ankle and the feet are 90 degrees. And let's put the chest down on the shin and lean as close to that foot as you can get. If you want, you can put that one arm behind your back and then the stretch intensifies. And take a deep breath in and sink your body into the floor as you breathe out. Nice deep breaths and let it go. And come up. And if you come up like with your hands behind your back, it's actually way more challenging to do this with your hands behind your back. And lean that shoulder towards the outside knee, or you can just put your hands on the knee and pull your torso towards it. Oh. As soon as I put my hands behind my back and lean that shoulder towards the knee, I feel a difference in my hip, almost like I'm gonna get a cramp. All right, let's reach for that back foot. Ooh. Or again, hands behind the back, leaning the torso and shoulder towards the back foot. Lots of choices. Ooh. This just takes more hip flexors when you're not using your hands. You actually have to like lean. Well, I must have done something because now I'm sweating. And you can keep your hands behind your back or put them by the front knee or on the floor. Push that knee into the floor again. This time we're just going to lift the back, the foot up. And again, hands behind the back. Whole different story, pushing that shoulder towards the back foot. Deep breath. Put the foot down. Lift the whole leg. Ah. Hold. Five, four, three, two, one. Put that foot down. Push the knee into the floor and twist your body away again. So nice because I know I'm getting those hip flexors all stretched out. Yeah, let's do the other side. Usually the second side we do is seems to be the harder one because always seem to go for the easy side first. All right. So 90-90 angles, ankles, knees, everything. Right? Oh, I didn't do the pinwheel, did I? Oh, pinwheel first. Thanks, Mike. All right, pinwheel first. Arms at chest or on the floor, and we're doing a torso circles. Wow. Torso circles. Sounds like a donut you can get at Tim Hortons. Okay, change direction now. My body keeps trying to compensate, and my knees keep trying to lift off the floor. Push that back knee into the floor. Twist your body away. Ow. Really feeling that one. I woke up with a tender back. It's because I hit my head, which bent my neck, which bent my spine. It's all coming back together again. Hey, don't do that. I have a microphone and I probably scared the crap out of everybody. You're not ticklish. All right, back to center. 99. So much trouble. You're grounded. All right. Ankles and knees, 90 degrees. Down on that shin. Ooh. Close to the foot as you can get. If you want, you could put your arm behind your back while you're. That way your shoulder will rest right on that shin. Deep breath in. I find this super intense in my glute on the leg that's forward and the front and the back of that leg, all around the whole hip. Deep breath in. Come back up. All right, so you can either grab that outside knee and pull your torso towards it, or put your hands behind your back and lean that shoulder towards that knee, which for me is almost causing a cramp. Right, lean it for towards that back foot. And I'm just leaning my shoulder and my torso without using my hands. I actually find it more intense. Push that knee into the floor and lift the foot. And if you can, push your shoulder towards that back foot. Wrong direction, Mike. Yeah, shoulder towards the back foot. Oh. Foot down, Lift the whole leg. Here we go. 5, 4, 3, 2. And down. Push the knee into the floor and twist your body away. Oh. Duper felt that one. All right, grab your band. This one is so silly. It's actually super effective, but it looks like you're not really doing anything. So I'm going to put my band on the balls of my feet. Be careful, you don't want to hit yourself in the face with the bands. Mindful, nice, the straightest spine you can imagine. Now hinge at the hip forward. Pointing my toes towards my face. Hinge forward. Seems like you're not even moving, eh? Sometimes I'll go back to the beginning, take a deep breath in, and then as I breathe out, lean forward. These hamstrings are going to be super rebellious. So I'm going to do this, put my band aside and take my right leg. I'm going to pull it over and bend it, put my knee on top of my other knee. Okay, and then touch your toes. If you want, you can rock forward and back. Take a deep breath in as you're going away from the toes. And breathe out as you go towards the toes. And hold if you can. That's even more intense than just using the band, I think. Sit up. I'm going to put that foot now on the floor. So the bottom of my foot's on the floor. And this is my right knee. So I'm going to hug it with my left arm. Then I'll take my free right hand. I'm going to turn my body and put it behind me. Twist as far away as I can. So now we're stretching that thoracic spine again. And your hip. Get to breathe. Back to center. Straighten your legs. Now get your other leg, bend it, and try to put your knee on top of the other knee. Oh. Hip cramp. And I'm going to reach for those toes. You want to really intensify it. Point the toes towards your face. And I'm just going to pulse forward in the beginning here. Breathing. Take a deep breath in as I come up. And breathe out as I go forward. And hold if you can. Floor flat, hug it, this is my left knee, so I'm going to hug it with my right arm, right into my chest if I can, and then my free left hand's going to go all the way behind me, and I'm going to turn my body as far behind me as possible. Ay, you said you wanted to twist your body. Okay, back to center again. So now let's do the spine. So I'm gonna lie on my side. Bring your knees up so they're parallel to your hips. And take those arms and go all the way back to behind. Ow. Ooh, sure felt that one. Alligator stretch, come back forward. And go again. Bring those knees up. There you go. Okay, we'll quickly do a shoulder sweep. So I'm going to support my neck, put my thumb down, and do a half circle. Keep the thumb towards the floor. Oh my goodness, that's so tight in the front. That's from those chest flies. I could do this shoulder sweep for days. It's so tight, the front of my chest. All right. And again, we'll go back to the arms in front, but this time, praying hands, so your elbows are bent. And that bottom leg, I'm going to straighten out. So my top leg, the knee, is on the floor. If you want to take your bottom hand, you can hold that knee right down. So now we have our goal post. Drop it all the way behind. Do not let your feet lift off the floor. Go, right? I feel this in my lower back and my chest, front of my shoulder. Deep breath in. Let it go. Let gravity pull that arm back. I'm going to grab my other foot that's down there with a straight leg and pull it up towards my butt so I can stretch my quad at the same time. It's called doing the pretzel. Keep those shoulders flat. Great, I'm going to switch sides. Gently roll over. Keep it in a pretzel position. Our side. Knees and hips parallel. We're doing the alligator stretch first. All the way back. Thinking things, I gotta be me. Can't get in trouble. Right, let's support that neck. Shoulder sweep, so thumb to the floor. Doing a half circle. You don't want your arm going across your body. Just doing a rainbow shape. All the way to behind. And forward again. We do. Tra-la-la-la-la. All the way back. Wee. It's funny, I'm doing this and my hand is tingling. Now I know why my hand fell asleep earlier. Woke up with my hand asleep last night. Tight shoulders, that's what that's from. All right. Let's straighten that bottom leg. Put the knee on the floor, the top leg. Bottom arm's gonna hold that knee down. I'm gonna goal post my arm and let it just fall behind me and hang. I'm gonna let gravity do that stretch. Deep breath in and let go of those tight muscles. And if you so desire, you could drop that other foot and pull it towards your butt, but you want your shoulders flat on the floor. But the more you pull that foot, the more you're going to stretch that front quad. Whew. Ay, ay, ay. Deep breath in. Let that body sink into the floor. Gonna gently roll onto my back. I'm going to put my arms in a goalpost position again, and then I'm just going to turn my head side to side. Stretch that neck. Back to center. I'm going to stretch my legs nice and straight and my arms straight so they're by my ears. I'm going to pretend my body's on one of those stretchers and reach my limbs away from my body. Reach, stretch. Deep breath in. Let it go and sink into the body, into the floor. Bring my right knee to my chest. And while you're doing that, you might as well do an ankle circle. Change direction. Oop, crickety crack. I'm gonna try and bring my knee back up a bit, and I'm gonna turn my leg so I'm pulling my foot towards my face. Stretch the back of my hip. Straighten that out, straighten the whole leg, and if you can, pull that calf towards your face. I have a slight bend in my knee just because. Anti-hyperextension. Now, if you want, you can hinge your ankle so your toe goes to the ceiling, then it goes to your base and back and forth. And again, keep your neck on the floor and try and pull that leg closer to you. Deep breath in, let go. Right, I'm gonna lower that leg and pull my left knee into my chest. And I might as well do an ankle circle. direction. Bring my knee up a bit, and then I'm gonna grab that foot and turn my leg towards my knees. So I'm kind of pushing my knee away from me and the foot towards me. Just bring that leg up and straighten it. Put my hands on my calf or the back of your leg. I'm gonna pull it towards my face. Oh, that's so clean. Deep breath in. Just let it go. I'm gonna point my toes to my face, toes to the ceiling. Just hinging at that ankle. All right, deep breath in. Pull that leg further. Let it go. Oh, I think I'm gonna get a cramp or a spasm. That is tight business. Ooh-wee. I'm gonna bring both knees to my chest. All right, let's teeter side to side, hugging those knees. Just want to loosen up that lumbar spine. We're going to open it up a bit too. So I'll go back to center and I'm going to hug my knees to my chest from the back of my legs. And then I'm going to put the bottoms of my feet towards the ceiling. And if you can, grab your hands on the outsides of your feet. Pull those knees towards the floor and your feet apart. Feet apart, knees towards the floor. Deep breath in. Let it go. Let it go. Now roll up into a seated position. The bottoms of my feet together. All right, you're going to want that space. Go back where you were. Okay, so I'm going to hug the bottom of my feet and pull my body towards the feet. And then I'm going to let go of the feet and reach my hands as far forward as I can. And as I come back, I'm going to go all the way, one vertebrae at a time, click, 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 until I get to the floor in the lying position. And then reach my arms all the way up by my ears and stretch. And while you got your arms on the floor beside your ears, you're going to bring your knees together and you're going to drop them side to side. You want, you can take them all the way to the floor, rest, and then go all the way to the other side, rest. Just taking turns, either twist the top of your body or twist the bottom. We're just stretching out that spine. Knees together. Then go back into the butterfly position, which is the bottoms of your feet touching. Let those knees hang out towards the floor. Gravity's gonna open up those hips. And if you can, bring your heels towards your tailbone. Just a little extra, there we go. And then take those arms by your ears and we're gonna swing up into the seated position again. And reach as far forward as you can go. Far forward as you can go. Reach. And all the way back down again, one vertebrae at a time. Click, click, click. I always feel so nice on my back when I do this one. And reaching those arms as far away from my body towards the wall above my head. All the way back up again, sitting. I'm gonna face forward now. I got my feet together. I'm gonna take my left leg and just take it out on an angle, 45 degree angle, and then bring that right foot, the bottom of it's just gonna go on the inside of my thigh. Right. Now I'm gonna put my right knee that's bent. So my right hand is gonna go behind my back. And then I'm going to take my left ear and put it towards my shoulder. Again, take your left hand and put it on the right ear. Push that right ear right into the hand towards the ceiling. Stretch. Kind of intense, I know. And then come back to center. So I'm still in this position with my left leg out. So I'm going to take my left hand. My right arm can come back forward, rest on the knee. I'm going to take my left hand. My whole forearm is going to go on the floor. And I'm going to take the right hand and reach it right over my head. And try to keep both butt cheeks on the floor while I do this. Really good for stretching all around the gluteus medius, the lower back, the hip. Let's reach over and do the other side. The other side should be easier. And back up. Let's switch legs. Right leg out at an angle. Bottom of my left foot on the inside of my thigh. Oh. So now my left knee's bent, so I'm gonna put my left arm behind my back. And my right ear is gonna go towards that shoulder. Put my right hand on that top ear and push it towards the ceiling into that hand. Kind of an intense stretch. Especially if you got a tight or sore neck. And don't forget to breathe. And when I come back to center, I got my right leg straight. So the whole forearm of my right side is going to go on the floor. My left arm's going to go over my head. And I'm going to try not to lift my butt cheeks off the floor. Around, reach the other direction. What? Ow. Ow. Uh-oh. Somebody. Somehow we ran out of time. How did that happen? Boop. It's your fault, Mike. I saw that. That smack idea. That was awesome.